Mastercam 2024 has some simple changes in the wireframe functions that will make modeling easier for new and experienced users alike. This video will serve as a refresher for some of the existing functionality and showcase the new enhancements to Edit Spline and the new Dynamic Trim tool, which brings back functionality from the old Trim Break Extend. Let's look at the wireframe demo file for some examples on how to use these functions. This file is set up to demonstrate all of the methods within Dynamic Trim. There are examples with instructions for how to use each method. Most of these methods you should be fairly familiar with, but one I really want to highlight is Trim 3 Entities. With Trim 3 Entities, you are really trimming the first two entities to the third. For this reason, the order of selection is very important. The three examples show how you can extend or trim wireframe depending on your selections. The first example shows extending and trimming lines up to their intersection point. The second example shows how all three lines can be trimmed. And the third shows how you could extend lines through their intersection point in some instances. At the end, you will see two new methods, lengthen and shorten. As their name suggests, they can be used to make wireframe longer or shorter respectively. They have been broken into their own separate methods to help avoid confusion and make the workflow easier to understand. With the lengthen method, you can only make a line longer, and with the shorten method, you can only make it shorter. This removes the need to use any negative numbers like you would have had to with extend, so you always know which way the wireframe will be changed. This is the same way that the current Modify Length tool works. Next, let's look at a new feature in the Edit Spline tool. Under the Refit Spline dropdown, the last option is Edit Spline. This tool is almost the same as in 2023, except for the Align End Tangents checkbox. Checking this will allow you to change the endpoints of a spline to be tangent to the endpoints of another piece of wireframe. To do this, select the spline you want to change. Click on the endpoint you want to change, then click and drag the gnomon to the endpoint of the wireframe you want to make it tangent to. Make sure you have Preserve selected before moving on to the second endpoint. As you can see, both ends of the spline are now tangent to the semicircle. With these functions, Mastercam's wireframe modeling is easier to use and more powerful than ever before.